Our global mixed martial arts rule set in place. A 15-minute fight will be judged in its entirety and not round by round. Here's Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the home of Martial Arts One Championship! Live from the Philippines, this is 1-164 Pacio versus Brooks! And now we begin with 3 5-minute rounds of bantamweight MMA. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he stands at 5'8" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 13 wins and 5 losses. Training out of T-Rex MMA and Tough Guys International, representing the Philippines, T-Rex Zamboanga! And introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 5'7" tall, weighing in at 144.75 pounds. Training out of Team Lakai, representing the Philippines, Antonis Savileno. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Mohammed Sulaiman.
Center, please. Center. Right, you both understand the rules. Okay, let's keep this clean. Keep it active. Obey my instructions at all times. Touch gloves if you want. Back to your corners.
Final instructions from our referee, Mohammed Sulaiman, from inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines, as we kick off 1-164 Pacio versus Brooks. A bantamweight contest. Adonis Civilino, Andrick Zamboanga.
Ready?
Both men rearing to go, nodding at each other from across the circle. They've known each other on the local scene for a number of years. They've looked forward to this moment.
Two of the coolest names in one championship, Drex and Adonis. I'm liking this matchup. Early leg kicks thrown. Nice big left hand thrown by Drex.
Right hand there from Civilino, looking for a takedown. They are back against the wire here. Chance for the knees. Here's one from Zamboanga.
Beautiful balance showcased early by Zamboanga. Drex was, or Adonis was deep into that body lock, had the hands clasped together. And Drex was able to balance and back his way up onto the wall. So that was an effective takedown strategy. Now, Adonis is dropping down into a single leg. Looks like he might be trying for a high crotch here. Let's see if he can turn the corner. He does just that. It's very important for Drex not to concede this takedown. Very good from Adonis to try and get the legs too. Now, you're gonna look for Drex to try to take one of his legs out. Usually the bottom leg. Yep, there he is. Now he can work his way back up to the wall.
Solid start here for Adonis Civilino, right in front of his corner with his coach Mark Sangal giving instructions there. From Team Lakai in Baguio City. A little popping right hand from Civilino.
Yeah, a lot of pressure early coming from Civilino. He knows he doesn't really want to stand and trade with Drex. Drex is a very good striker, so Drex is going to try to create a little bit of separation here. Using the forearm to frame on the face, but Adonis is staying so tight to him.
You will see all the Team Lakai members tonight in the familiar red trunks they're so famous for. Just caution there from the referee not to hold the fence for Adonis Civilino. Zamboanga, better position now from Drex, takes the back of Civilino, and the crowd responding for Zamboanga.
That was good balance and patience shown by Zamboanga there to nullify the single leg, sneak around, take the back. He's got one hook in. Let's see if he can sink the other one in. Yes, he does. But Savino does a good job of peeling legs off, right? So he can spin into the guard now, work his way back up to the top. That was good.
Back on the feet, almost halfway through this opening round, set for 3 by 5. Overhook on that right arm, breaks it now. Nice little gut-munching knee, couple of peppered fists there from Drex Zamboanga. And dances out of the way. High kick. Double forearm guard from Adonis Civilino.
Now Drex is shooting in for the takedown. Good defense showcased by Civilino. Turn him around, press him against the wall. Drops down.
Nice. Folds him with that knee to the midsection to Zumbawanga.
That was a nice tight palm, goes right into the knee. And then Adonis tries to triangle the legs again. Zumbawanga showcasing good balance using that overhook. See how he's kind of got that wizard with that right hand? And that's able enabling him to work his way back up to his feet, back into the clinch, throwing those knees.
Oh, beautiful use of the tight clinch from Trick Zumbawanga. Drops down, hoping for a double leg here to Civilino. Still maintaining the vertical base, and now Zumbawanga goes down, takes a seated position. What can Civilino work from here?
He's doing a great job of attacking these takedowns. He's got to be careful not to gas himself out. He's still got a long way to go in this one. Works around, takes it back as Zumbawanga tries to escape out.
Civilino wants to strangle him.
It's important. Zumbawanga can't concede this position. Looks like he's okay. He's going to turn in. That was good.
The sold-out crowd in Manila loving every moment of this opening fight. Inside the guard now. Up Drex Zumbawanga. Zumbawanga's corner saying, come on, Drex, you've got to work.
Salino is pushing a ferocious pace early in this matchup. And training at altitude out there in Baguio for 4 months must have done him some good, because he is supremely confident that he can keep his pace going the entire time.
Under 1 minute to go in the first round. What an impressive opening here for Adonis Civilino as Trex glances towards his corner. Hosting up on that right arm. Can he go? Oh, it takes a knee to the snuggin! Wow!
And Adonis is out muscling a guy who just a few months ago fought at 170 pounds. 35 pounds up from this weight, so it just goes to tell you just how strong Adonis is, but he ate a knee.
High knee there from Zumbawanga, corner-lighted, planting right hand from Adonis Civilino, throws the right hand again, clinches up now with Zumbawanga, drops down, locks onto a single leg here, does Adonis.
Man, Adonis is realizing the magnitude of this moment.
Final seconds of what has been a fantastic opening 5 minutes of action. Elbows to the trapezius area there. Stop. From Trick Zumbawanga, and we go to the towel.
Ferocious pace pushed by Adonis Civilino as he was just attacking the takedown, but all he could really do was press Drex up against the wall and not really secure the takedown and hold Drex down. Drex did a good job of continuously popping back up and staying up on his feet. Look at this, that was a nice clinch into the knee, and that's gonna be an important weapon because Adonis is so aggressive in getting to these locks, right? Getting to these body lock positions, Drex might be able to pull his head down and land some more of these knees. That was a good little body kick to a right hand combination thrown by Adonis.
Ready to rock and roll to the second round, set for three. From inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in the Philippines. Fantastic opening 5 minutes for Adonis Civilino in the red. Drex Zumbawanga in the black. Mohamed Sulaiman gets us underway. Inside leg early from Adonis. Overhand right to the clinch, and Zumbawanga got out of town.
Yeah, those short punches are really important for Zumbawanga, especially the uppercut. I'd like to see him just start throwing that jab-uppercut combination. He's got a beautiful one, and he's going to need it here as Adonis is letting his game plan very clearly be displayed. He wants this takedown. He wants this body lock. He wants to get this match to the ground.
Single leg here from Civilino. Hooks the leg, looking for a takedown, gets it now. Top position for Adonis.
That was nice. Turn the corner, put Drex down. But Drex pops right back up. He is hard to hold down.
Popping right hand there from Civilino, knee to the inside thigh. Lots of instructions now from the corner of Trick Zumbawanga. Frames off, throws the elbow, nicely done from Zumbawanga. Two punch combination misses. Down to the legs again, hoping for a takedown. Adonis Civilino.
I know I spoke a lot about the gas tank of Civilino, seeing if he can keep up this pace and if he fades in the later part of this match, but I'm also starting to wonder about Drex's gas tank because he's having to consistently be on the defensive. And it's hard to defend a lot of these takedowns and keep popping back up once you get pulled down like this. Good little knee shield by Drex, working to the wizard. But Savino is just tenacious. Good job by Drex to circle around to the back.
Overhooking that arm is Adonis Civilino. Drex looking for a takedown now. Top position for Zamboanga. What can he do from here?
That was nice from Zamboanga to turn the tables and put the wrestler on his back. Not typically a place that wrestlers like to be, so it'll be interesting to see what kind of guard recovery or basically half guard at this point that Civilino has. First thing he needs to do with his right arm is dig the underhook, right? Underneath the arm of Zamboanga so that he can start turning onto his side and create a little bit of movement here. But as long as Drex has that underhook on his right, on his left side, he's gonna be able to flatten Civilino out.
Civilino trying to return to his feet. Drex not winning, go here, touch the back now. Turns back into him, half guard position again.
Good scramble by Drex to stay on top. Now he's back into the half guard position, driving that shoulder into the chin, trying to redirect pressure so that Civilino is forced to flatten out. But Civilino, now he digs the underhook, and now he starts to scramble back out.
You can knee the head of a grounded opponent under our global mixed martial arts rule set. Right hands here from Zamboanga, top position. 2 minutes remaining, second round of three after a very good opening 5 minutes from Adonis Civilino.
Drex is trying to cut through the half guard here with a knee slice, but Adonis chooses to give up his back in the process. Good control right here from Drex as he's able to maintain position. And he might try to step over into the mount, but it looks like he's caught in the half guard, but he's still kind of in side control here.
Solid left hand landing for Drex Zamboanga. You can see some swelling under the left eye of Adonis Civilino.
Let's see if Civilino can turn around here. He's got one of his legs. He's just kind of holding on to the left leg there of Zamboanga just to not give up side mount completely, but he does. And now Zamboanga might be able to get the back.
Zamboanga mounts him.
Nice.
What can Drex do now? Takes the back. Under a minute remaining.
Good control right there from Drex Zamboanga to maintain position, get the back control. Now he's got both hooks in, and he's fighting for a rear naked choke. He's got 45 seconds. That arm looks like it's close under the chin, but good defense by Civilino. Might give up mount here. Might be a good time for Zamboanga to start dropping some ground pound.
Civilino hoped to throw an elbow off of his back there. Zamboanga looks to posture up. Civilino back to his feet. Nicely done from Adonis.
And that's good fundamental grappling and wrestling. Both these guys are doing all the right stuff to maintain that position and not get submitted. And not really concede position for very long at all.
Ends up leg kick from Adonis Civilino. Throws a right hand. Zamboanga with an uppercut. High kick from Civilino, Zamboanga with the hands to bring it home at the end of the round. 2-2, two down, one to go.
Oh yeah, third round is all gonna come down to gas tank. Who can dig deep? What do you call it? Intestinal fortitude? Isn't that your slang right there that you like to use to dig deep when times get tough? Nice little elbow. And then it was just like a huge chunk of time with top control for Zamboanga. He was just one step ahead once Civilino was on the bottom. There's the twins, the Rutolo brothers, and the flyweight champion. That's a lot of gold right there between the three of them right there. Lightweight submission grappling champion and the flyweight submission grappling champion. I'm sure they're enjoying these grappling exchanges.
I hope you're enjoying it, folks.
If there's a chance for you to take him down, you take down. Force yourself to do the takedown.
You hear Team Lokai telling Adonis Civilino, get the takedown. If the opportunity presents itself, get Zamboanga to the ground. Third and final round. Outside leg kick to open up. Flurry of hands from Zamboanga. Zamboanga goes down the center corridor, peppers the body back to the head. Sweat flying off the brow of Civilino. High knee from Civilino. Picks up Drex. Double leg.
It looked like Civilino wobbled Zamboanga for a minute there.
Exactly what his coach asked for. The takedown in the opening 30 seconds from Adonis Civilino.
Nice little entry into the double leg. Was able to get Drex down. Let's see if Drex can work his way back up to his feet. It looks like Drex is hurt slightly.
Andrade wants to keep him down.
Beautiful scramble, though. Nice little switch there to pull his leg out, get back up to the standing position. Fundamentals are strong in these two.
Zambuanga. A cut, it looks like, maybe on the bridge of the nose of Drex Zambuanga from that flurry at the start of the round by Adonis Sivilino. Some knees here from Sivilino. What action this one has had from the opening bell. There have been no slow moments. Nice rising knee off the left there from Zambuanga. Once again, folks, our judges are scoring. It is an overall bout and not round by round. Launches the right hand as Sivilino.
Drex had some good moments in this fight, especially there at the end of the second, but a lot of the first 5 minutes was all Sivilino, and he was able to build up a nice little lead. But you have to wonder how the judges are going to look at this. You know, are they going to see the takedowns of Sivilino, or are they going to see this newfound aggression coming from Zambuanga?
Again, Adonis's corner wanted him to go for the takedown. That's what he's looking for again. Double leg here from Adonis.
Yeah, they might as well take Drex's strength away from him. That seems to be that, those boxing combinations. He throws good uppercuts and hooks, and this type of strategy right here, staying close to him, attempting this takedown, eliminates his ability to do that.
The One Warrior Series Philippines winner in the red trunks, Adonis Sivilino. Zambuanga says he knows him well, he studied him well, had found some holes in the defense of Sivilino. Single leg, gives up on that. Halfway through the final round here, Dragon.
But we're also seeing takedown defense from Zambuanga, right? You know that Sivilino wants to get this match to the ground, so just by keeping this fight standing, we're seeing that Zambuanga could be scoring points in the judges' eyes. Really tough to score this one. Nice takedown landed by Zambuanga.
Beautiful takedown, Zambuanga. Side control for him now.
Sivilino needs to work with a little bit of urgency right here. He's got 2 minutes to do something, to get back, at least has to get back up or at least reverse the position.
Under 2 minutes remaining. Just punches the ear there, does Zambuanga. Looks for an elbow, well blocked though by Sivilino. Palm heel strike there from Adonis Sivilino. Don't see it so much, the good old fashioned palm heel strike, but works effectively. Still side control for Zambuanga.
You can hear Denise screaming, keep him tight, make him scramble, make him exhaust himself. Really important for Zambuanga to start doing some ground and pound. Yeah, you got to score some points here. But referee Mohamed Sulaiman is letting these guys work.
A highly physical contest. Both men have ground on each other. And now have 60 seconds remaining. Who can bring it home strongly? It will be a difficult one for the judges, I believe. And Zambuanga in half guard. In full guard. Oh, nicely tracked that elbow down to Drex.
Yeah, that's what he needs to do. He needs to score some points with some ground and pound. In a match that's this close, every single strike he can land from this top position is going to count. Oh, that was nice. He let him up kick and then he slid out of the way to secure the almost the side control position. Adonis is doing a good job utilizing his legs to get back into position, but Drex was able to secure it. Now he's landing knees.
Knees to the head of a grounded opponent. Perfectly legal side control. Here comes Zambuanga. Clucking elbows to end the fight from Drex Zambuanga. I do not want to be a judge on this one, Dragon.
Yeah, that was close. The first half of the match, it seemed like it went to Sivilino, but in the last half, it looked like Zambuanga had more of the moments, back and forth, constant action, incredible scrambles, two very tough Filipino warriors. Great fight.
Wherever you're watching, folks, let us know how you scored it. @ONE Championship across all your social media platforms. Do you have it for Drex Zumbawanga? Do you have it for Adonis Sivilino? Both men believe they've done enough to win. I see Dom Lau moving towards the circle. It could be very close indeed. Mohamed Sulaiman gathers both athletes. Who will kick off 1-1-64 with a win? Let's go to Dom Lau for our result.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Drex Zumbawanga!
It's a sweet, sweet victory for Drex Zumbawanga. A massive audience pop for the T-Rex. After a wonderful fight, he is now with the Dragon.
Drex, what a back!